So Taichi's bizarre adventure continues in this episode of Digimon Adventure 2020 Reboot Series. This has the potential to be one of, if not the most divisive episode in the entire history of Digimon. And yes, I'm including the original adventure, Tamers, Cross Force and all the other seasons. There are bound to be people who absolutely love this episode and there are bound to be people who absolutely hate this episode if we are considering the lore of the Digimon world. So hello and welcome to NYZ, my name is Soham and today we are going to talk about Digimon Adventure 2020 Reboot Series, episode number 50. But before that, if you're new here, then please consider subscribing to the channel since I do weekly anime and manga related content along with a bunch of other stuff. With that being said, let's begin the video. Now, like I said in the beginning, this is bound to be probably one of the most divisive episodes in the entire history of Digimon. There were certain elements of this episode which were absolutely amazing, unpredictable and awesome. Scenes which basically reminded me why I was a fan of Digimon in the very first place as a kid. And at the very next moment, I'm like, what the hell is going on? Why is this going on? Why is this even happening? How is this even possible? This was my entire reaction throughout the entire episode and you will understand why in just a bit. So essentially, the plot of this episode is very simple because it's basically showing the battle that took place between Valkyriemon and Millennium Mon. He is initially kind of defeated, but later on, because of the powers of two unexpected evolutions, they kind of win the day. So what happens here is that the rest of the Digidestined are kind of engulfed in the space-time continuum barrier, which is currently present inside the mouth of Millennium Mon, and he's compressing this area. And if nothing is done, all of them are going to perish for sure. So at this very moment, Yamato tries to do something and he's trying to expand or attack upon this particular area. And this gives idea to the other Digidestined as well, so that they also utilize their moves. It's kind of unfortunate that Yamato was not utilized in this particular episode. Yeah, I know everyone was expecting to see Omegamon or maybe even Omegamon Alter S. But I'm fine with it. I think that Omegamon Alter S or Omegamon X is probably going to come up later on. There's still 16 episodes left. But it's kind of sad that in the main fight against Millennium Mon, Yamato was not utilized at all. Just having a Metal Garurumon moment is not equal to him actually doing something in the battle. Rather, the most impressive MVPs of this episode were indeed Taichi and the other two Digidestined, that is TK and Hikari. The two kids, the two absolute kiddies, are the ones who actually overcame everything. And here we finally get to see the evolution into Holy Dramon and God Dramon. And damn, this was awesome. They were huge. They were absolutely freaking huge. And on the topic of huge, do you know who is huge, who is big? It's Millennium Mon. This guy is a behemoth. This guy is an absolute monstrosity. I don't really remember the canon of the series or lore of the series as to what exactly was the size of this guy, but my goodness, this is huge. And even later on, Zed Millennium Mon appears in the show as well, and he's even freaking bigger. But basically what happens here is that Taichi and Agumon are trying to evade the attacks of Millennium Mon, but they are of course unable to do it because of the disparity in power and size, and in the end, they are beaten down, they are thrown into the water, and to this, all the other Digidestined are kind of cheering upon them, and this is the light of hope, this is the light of evolution, and this is also the thing which triggers the Digivolution from Holy Dramon and God Dramon, and at the same time, Taichi and Valkyriemon also wake up. And what follows next is a very dynamic battle, because here we get to see God Dramon and Holy Dramon literally punching and biting into Millennium Mon. This was really good. And also something very important to note here is that just like the episode overall, the animation also was a very mixed bag experience. On one hand, we had absolutely amazing orgasmic Sakuga moments. At the very next moment, we get to see this blob of characters who are just standing there and was so bad. It was so bad looking. So overall, this episode was a really big mix of extremities. On one hand, something is very good, and on the other hand, something is very terrible. So that's the basic gist of this episode in a way. And after a while, Holy Dramon and God Dramon are finally able to defeat Millennium Mon, and his busters and everything are kind of taken back. And all of that is fine. All of that is fine and dandy. But after this defeat, Taichi notices something in the sky, and here at this particular moment, the music is pretty good. I don't really know what is the OST used here, but the music is really good. And what he notices in the sky is a huge behemoth, which is indeed Zed Millennium Mon. Now his name is obviously not taken here. Kyoshiro tries to detect it, but it says that this is an unknown Digimon. And in the background, we are seeing the reactions from the other Digimon as well, including Lopmon, Leomon, and the others who are witnessing this climactic battle from the ground. And according to Lopmon, this is the eventual destruction of the world because Zed Millennium Mon's attacks are literally bringing about apocalypse. Dude, this was so damn good. And also on the topic of apocalypse, I'm sorry, I just forgot to mention it. I'm going to add it here. I'm not going to edit it anymore. So the attacks of Holy Dramon and God Dramon were also freaking amazing. And I don't know really why, but I got a lot of Dragon Ball vibes here, especially from the God Fist. It really reminded me of the Dragon Ball Super Broly movie. And Holy Dramon using the apocalypse move was also really great, kind of reminding me of Zamasu for that matter. Honestly, there were a lot of references and moments dedicated to the other shows of Toei Animation, the most obvious ones being One Piece as well as Dragon Ball. Because the situation surrounding Wargreymon and Taichi standing up to Millenniummon really looked like Luffy going up against Dragon Form of Kaido. And at the same time, towards the very end of this episode, we get to see a lot of Dragon Ball references, of course. I'm going to talk about it in just a bit. But here we finally get to see Zed Millenniummon using his most devastating attacks, and this was really good. It's really bringing about literal apocalypse upon the world of digital world. But to this, the light of the digital world shines. The brooch is once again kind of important here. I really didn't think that this would be kind of the symbolization of the crown or the willpower of the digital world, but it is releasing its energy. The light of hope is being released here, and it is being collected towards the chosen children. Taichi takes up this light, and with the help of Wargreymon, he charges up to Zed Millenniummon, charging a Gia Force. But of course, this Gia Force is not strong enough, so what shall be done? The answer is of course a Genki Dama. This was such a classic Dragon Ball reference, and I know this might sound cheesy, but this was really something which I was not expecting to see, yet this was very satisfying at the very same time, because the light of hope, the power of the entire digital world and all its creatures are now being poured and gathered into the Gia Force, and this makes it swell up. All the other remaining Digimons are also sending up their power, and even Holy Dramon and God Dramon also send their power up to the Gia Force, and this now becomes a huge behemoth thing, and it absolutely obliterates Zed Millenniummon. And that is the ending of this episode. In the end, it was kind of a fun breather moment. There were some minor moments of Mimi and Taichi. I don't know if this is hinting towards some kind of a ship or not. I'm not really worried about all of those things, so it's not really that important of a deal. But yeah, of course, the biggest question here is that Millenniummon and even Zed Millenniummon for that matter were definitely nerfed. I know that Digimon purists are absolutely going to hate it. I was also kind of taken aback by how easily Millenniummon and Zed Millenniummon were taken aback when we saw these same kids struggling so much against Orochimon for that matter. But I guess it's fine. It's not the best episode. This is obviously going to be one of the most divisive episodes of all time because of the choices that it made. But it was daring in its approach, and it was stunning and beautiful wherever it applied it properly. My only gripe here is that how the power was accumulated and how only two of the Holy Digimon actually gave up their powers. If the show actually utilized some elements from, say, something like Digimon Cross Wars, where they had the digislots for the ancient Digimons, I think something like that could have been applied here, where the souls of all the other ancient Digimons were brought about here, and after absorbing their power, the Gia Force was powerful enough to take down Millenniummon. If that was actually applied, I think that this episode would have been a lot better, but still overall this was fine. This is definitely once again the most divisive episode of Digimon so far in my opinion, but I'm kind of happy, it's alright, I'm giving them a pass. Moreover, 16 more episodes are left, so I'm really excited to see where the story eventually lands, and hopefully, just hopefully, this does not remain just a Taichi's bizarre adventure, and the other Digimon and other Digestin also get to get their shine. So anyway, that's it for today guys, thank you so much for joining in. What do you guys think about all of these things? Please do let me know in the comment section below. So that's it for today guys, thank you so much for joining in. Please give this video a thumbs up if you like it, share it with your friends and subscribe to the channel for more. Also, please do join the channel membership for some very cool perks and features. And lastly, please do join the Discord server as well. We have a lot of discussions in relation to anime, manga and more. With that being said guys, this is WonderYC and I'll see you soon on the next one.